Okay guys, welcome back to the channel. As I said in the last video, I will be recording more training videos coming up. So today we are here in Foyle. This is where I usually train. I do most of my sessions here, so we will be training push today. I'll take you through. I'll be training with a good friend of mine, Walie. We haven't trained together in a good while. He's not here yet, but we're going to get cracking anyway to be here in a few minutes. So what we'll do is we'll keep it raw. We go through everything, we'll get on with our session, and then here and there throughout the video I will stop, I will explain kind of why we're doing things, and you will just get kind of an insight into the way we train, why we train that way, etc. And so the first training video getting done, so I hope you enjoy, and all like I said, I will talk you through it, and then I will catch you at the end as well, okay? Cheers guys, enjoy. So basically starting off with just kind of some warm-up exercises, get some blood into the shoulders, into the chest, etc. before we get started. And then we're going to start off with the cuff lateral raises, which I will go through in a second, okay? So like I said, just get some blood into the shoulders, into the chest, get everything firing, and then get into the session. Okay, so first up is cuffed side lateral raises. First up we have one set of 15, one set of 8 to 10. So two sets all together. You'll have a look, you'll be able to see when I'm running through the exercise itself. It's obviously for your side delts. I find I connect much better with an exercise like this rather than a standard, say, dumbbell side raise. So the aim here is when we get down to the bottom, when we get down into the lengthened position, we don't want to just kick the weight back up. We're focusing on pulling from the side delts rather than using momentum to swing the weight at all, okay? So, because it's on a cable as well, tension is fully on the delts at all times. So we're going to lengthen in. When it gets in here, we're not going to swing. We're going to focus on where we're pulling from and then drag that way rather than just reefing it, okay? Like we always say, it's about doing as much damage to the muscle as possible, not just moving as much weight from A to B as possible. The reason why I'd start off with, say, a cuffed raise at the moment is because I find it's very hard to get your delts short as the session progresses, okay? So I'll be going into a shoulder press after this. So when I do a cuffed lateral first, it's not going to take away the strength from my dumbbell press at all, but it's going to get my delts fired up. It's going to enable me to get my delts short before we even go into any of our movements. So once I get these done, my delts are going to be fired up. There's going to be blood in them. I'm going to be able to connect with my shoulder press a lot easier, and my joints are going to feel a lot more warm as I go to move some heavy weight. Big man decided to show up, so at the moment we are just warming up. We'll work up to, we're going to have two working sets, one set of say kind of 5 to 7, one heavier set of like 10 to 12, so we'll just work up in low rep ranges, just get a feel for the weight, make sure the joints are okay, and then save all the energy and the strength for them two big sets. I don't know what we work up for today. This is my first rotation on this session. And anytime I'm training with this guy, he always ends up making me hit PBs. So let's see what happens. We get warmed up on this, and then we work. last warm-up set, literally one or two reps, make sure it feels easy, and then we set ourselves up for that working set.
Finish it.
Yes. Okay, so first set done. Did a set of 6-7 minute squat. Second set, we drop the weight back a little bit. Around about 10 to 12. Happy enough, it's a good starting point. Like I said, my fourth session on this rotation. So 55s for 7. I'll take that and give it 4 or 5 weeks, I'll be up to the 65s, no doubt. But this fucking guy is gonna go 65s now. Bear in mind, this guy is only 20 years old as well. Fucking freaky. Switch it on. Yep. Right, let's go. Come on. Drive. Yep, let's go. Yep. Let's go. Good. Yep. Yes. Yep. Finish it. Come on. Control.
Yep. One. Yes. Three. Let's go. 5. Let's go. 6. Let's go. 7. I want two more, man. Let's go. Yeah. One more.
Let's go.
Oi. Let's go. Let's go. Finish it.
Yeah. Okay, so that's cuffs raises done, high incline dumbbell press done, 2 sets on each of them. As you can see, 2 sets is all we need. 4 sets in and we're smoked. So next up, low incline split machine press, so more so kind of onto chest. We're going to run 3 sets at this, a set of 8-10, a heavier set of 5-7, and then we pull it off at the last set and we hit a set of say 12-15. So again, a couple of warm-ups, low reps, and then we can straight into work.
Let's go. This one is you. This one. One more.
Let's go.
One more chance. Let's fucking go. Move it. Move it. I'm not helping. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
As you can see, like I said before, there's no moving way A to B. Every single rep is with a purpose. You know, so the aim is to be as strong as possible on movements with perfect form, okay? It's all good moving way from A to B, but if you're not stimulating that muscle like the way it's meant to be stimulated, you're not going to grow whatsoever, regardless of how much weight you move. So you'll see through all our sets, every rep is with a purpose. Every rep is, you know, stimulating the muscle as efficiently as possible. So that's the way they like to approach things. Yes. Yes. Come on. Come on. One more. One more. One more. One more. One more. Hey, drive. Finish. Finish.
Oh.
Yes. 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 Oh. Yeah, that's the one. Okay, so after low incline swim machine, on the dips for triceps, two sets here again, one heavier set of kind of 8 reps, and then back it off for the second set, a set of 12 to 15, so I'll back it off for a second set, I'll just go body weight, hard contractions, good stretches, and again, make sure every single rep is quality, and everything is on the tricep, not just moving the weight. So that's really all the kind of the compound stuff done, all the main movements. So heavy press for shoulders, heavy press for chest, dips for triceps, and then we're kind of onto the isolation stuff for push. So we're gonna hit cable flies for chest first. Okay, we're gonna go 2 sets of this, 1 set of 12 to 15, a second set of 12 to 15. On the second set, we go into a 2-point rest pause. So what we'll do there is we'll hit kind of 12 to 15 reps. We'll rest 15 seconds. We'll go to failure again with the exact same way. We'll rest 15 seconds again. And then one last time, we'll go to failure again with the same weight. So come to that last failure point, we literally be getting maybe 2-3 reps completely to failure. It's just a great way of kind of intensifying sets, kind of extending them and taking them to full failure. So this is the last exercise we will do for chest. So yeah, let's get into it, and then we'll see what's next. two sets of cable floors done. Basically, what you saw me do at the end of the last one there, that last rep, straight into a weighted stretch at the end there. Basically, chest is fully fatigued. Last rep is done. So I just open up the chest, let the weight kind of take it, and really kind of stretch them fibers. And basically, what that will do is that will, the chest is done, that will help fresh blood, fresh nutrients kind of rush into the chest when it's done. And then you get up, and it will literally just kind of fill with blood. That's chest finished. I move on to another side raise movement now for medial delts, side delts. So we are going to go cuffed raise again. I'm much rather kind of doing a raise with a cuff rather than holding onto any handle. I find it connects much more. So we're going to go single arm cuffed raise. One set of say 15 to 20 into a rest pause set. So hit 15 reps or so, 15 second rest. I'll finish off the failure again. Just one set each arm. So nearly there. Next up is on the triceps. Finish off with two tricep movements. One push down and an overhead extension. We're just going to work the long head of the triceps. So first up, we're going to go single arm row push down. One set of kind of 12 or 15, and then one set of say 20, slightly higher reps. So we'll drop the weight down for the second set. So two sets there, and then we move on to overhead extension and finish off push session. And with that. So this is my intro workout. At the moment it is 10 grams of creatine, 20 grams of EAAs, and on upper body days 60 grams of highly branched cyclic dextrin, which I touched on before, which is basically a fast digesting carb source. So yeah, just in case you're wondering what I was drinking during the session, that's my current kind of intro shake at the moment. Last exercise, like I said, overhead tricep extensions. As you can see, you'll see me doing these. I look very strange doing these. I have very bad mobility in my shoulders. So I literally have to kind of adjust myself. It doesn't look natural compared to the way some people would do an overhead extension. But you have to kind of, like, I am working on my mobility at the moment. I'm getting it worked on, I'm working on it myself, and it is improving massively. It just kind of came from years of neglecting stretching, mobility, kind of deep tissue work and stuff. So my shoulders are like very tight and things. So basically, on some exercises, I will just adjust my body in order to kind of feel an exercise, okay? So when you see someone doing an exercise, don't just copy them and do a movement just because you see someone doing it that way. If you feel, you know, you need to adjust your body to a certain way in order to maybe feel a movement that connect with it better, don't be afraid to do something different if it feels better for you. Don't just copy other people, because that's exactly what they're doing. Like you see me here, it looks funny compared to the way most people do it, but at the moment, it's what works for me and it's the way I connect with it. So sometimes you just kind of have to do what needs be in that moment and for that exercise. Okay, so that's our push session wrapped up. As you know, I'm just kind of reverse now of a dieting phase at the moment. So strength is still not where I want it to be. But in the next few weeks, like I said, it will start to shoot back up pretty fast. So I am excited for that. And we are going to go, like I said, this is the first kind of round of these sessions on my new program. So trying to set baseline numbers, see where the strength is at. And then we'll use the next kind of couple of months to build and progress on that. So it is a good starting point to be at. And I'm looking forward, you know, next time you see these sessions come again, you will see the strength and all progressing with it. So I'm excited for that. A lot of progress to come over the next couple of months. But thank you to Niall for recording today. I'm going to put Niall's details in the bio and stuff. A pleasure. And we will be recording more videos very, very soon as well. I'm going to try the best. A leg session, I think that would be very exciting. So yeah, I'll try to get that up soon. But basically, that's the push session. If anyone has any questions whatsoever about even the programming or anything whatsoever about the exercises, or I didn't explain anything in enough depth, shoot me a comment, shoot me a message on Instagram, and I'll be happy to kind of answer whatever questions you have. But yeah, I hope you found that somewhat insightful. Again, any suggestions whatsoever, if you want to see anything else, any other content on YouTube, etc., I'll be more than happy to take it on board and see what I can do going forward in the future. But yeah, thank you very much for tuning in, guys. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, and again, share if you did find it enjoyable or beneficial in any way. And yeah, go home now, eat, chill out, and yeah, enjoy the rest of the day. So thanks, guys. I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you very much.